So the inequality that we're trying to prove is that for any n greater than or equal to 1, f of n is less than or equal to 8 times g of n. So let's plug in the expressions for the functions f and g. So the inequality that we want to show is that 3n cubed plus 5n squared minus 7 is less than or equal to 8n cubed. So it may not be immediately obvious how to prove this inequality, but a good place to start is by looking at the positive coefficients of the terms of each expression. Observe that the sum of the positive coefficients on the left-hand side is equal to the coefficient 8 on the right-hand side. So we can express 8n cubed as the sum of two terms, one of which has a coefficient of 3 and the other of which has a coefficient of 5. Now we can compare the two expressions term by term. Each expression has a 3n cubed term, which are equal. Now let's look at the two terms with the coefficient 5. The term on the left is an n squared term. The term on the right is an n cubed term. Since n is greater than or equal to 1, we know that n cubed is greater than or equal to n squared. So the 5n squared term on the left is going to be less than or equal to the 5n cubed term on the right. Finally, the minus 7 term on the left doesn't have a counterpart in the expression on the right, but if we add a plus 0 on the right, we can use the fact that minus 7 is less than or equal to 0. So term by term, the expression on the left is less than or equal to the expression on the right, and this is exactly how the proof will go. We will show a sequence of inequalities, and in each inequality, we replace a term from the expression on the left with a term from the expression on the right. Each substitution will cause the expression to stay the same or get larger. Here is a sequence of inequalities that prove the fact that we want to show. As we proceed downwards, each expression is greater than or equal to the one that comes before. If each of these inequalities is true, then the first expression, which is equal to f of n, is less than or equal to the final expression, which is equal to 8 times g of n. In the first inequality, we just drop a minus 7 term. Dropping a minus 7 term will cause an expression to get larger. So 3n cubed plus 5n squared is greater than or equal to 3n cubed plus 5n squared minus 7. If we want to establish the inequality more concretely, we can start with the inequality that minus 7 is less than or equal to 0, which we know to be true. Then we can add a 3n cubed plus 5n squared to both sides. The resulting inequality is that 3n cubed plus 5n squared minus 7 is less than or equal to 3n cubed plus 5n squared, which is exactly the first inequality in the proof. In the next step, an n squared term is replaced by an n cubed term. Here we're using the fact that since n is greater than or equal to 1, then n cubed is greater than or equal to n squared. Because the coefficient 5 is positive, replacing the n squared by the n cubed term causes the expression to either stay the same or get larger. Again, if we want to establish the inequality more concretely, we can start with the inequality that n cubed is greater than or equal to n squared and multiply by 5. Then we add 3n cubed to both sides of the inequality. The result is that 3n cubed plus 5n cubed is greater than or equal to 3n cubed plus 5n squared, and that's exactly the second inequality in the proof. Now the rest is just algebra. Combining the 3n cubed and the 5n cubed term gives 8n cubed, which is equal to 8 times g of n.